Massey Hall, you're my favorite venue in the whole wide world. Massey Hall, oh yeah, you're on the menu of the greatest venues in the whole wide world.
Massey Hall is it's a church.
Massey Hall is legendary.
Massey Hall is a living story. And every night, one of the privileged few is given a chance to get up on that stage and to write a new line or a new paragraph. Or if you're Neil Young or Gordon Lightfoot, you've written entire chapters.
Massey Hall is a total pain in the ass. Because it's a hometown show for me, and you spend like the previous couple of days to the show worrying if you've looked after all your friends and family and what tickets they're getting and who's coming to the after show and who needs directions, and it's a total nightmare, and it's awesome.
Massey Hall is like the ultimate reward for working and playing music. It's a reward not everybody gets. It's a privilege to be on that stage, an honor. It's a gorgeous room. If every room you played was like Massey Hall, you could never complain about anything in your entire life, because it is grand and it's intimate. It's kind of the perfect size for connecting with an audience. I love it. Love it.
We're sitting here at the Cameron House, which is where it all started for me. So in 2006, I played here every Monday for an entire year, and I don't think there's a single show where I didn't, on the inside, pretend that I was playing at Massey Hall.
Playing at Massey Hall is one of those incredible rites of passage for a musician, especially a musician in Canada. It's one of those situations where you know all about all the musicians who have come before you, you know about over a century of history, and it's one of those things where not that many can lay claim to it, and once you've done it, nobody can take that away from you. So I think it's a combination of it being an incredible personal achievement for any musician who's playing there, and knowing that you've just entered that that exclusive club.
Performing at Massey Hall is the sort of the top of the step ladder, right? I mean, I think if you grow up in Toronto, for sure, you've seen shows at Massey Hall, and you recognize how meaningful they were to you. And so you can't really imagine when you're starting out that you would ever get to the point where you would be on that stage. You'd be popular enough to be on that stage. Royal would definitely be somebody that I feel like had a career trajectory that would end up in Massey Hall. I think that Royal also has the type of music that's suited for the building. If you have, first of all, he has a really good voice, and that it's a really good place to sing in. And if you have a sound that has some space in it, the building will just enhance everything you do. And it's a beautiful building to play in. So I think that's a good match. Royal and the building were a good match.
To finally see Royal headline, you know, Massey Hall on his own was I know a dream for him, but also it was great to sit in the audience and watch that happen.
Everything leading up to Massey Hall was an enormous checklist. You pick your set, you have your band, you think about what you want to say. There's all the promoting and the social media and the interviews, and there's just all these details. And suddenly it was the night of the show, and an hour before the show, and the promoter says, "Would you like someone to introduce you before you come out on stage?" And we jokingly were like, "Should get my mom to do it." And then everyone looked at each other, like all my bandmates and the crew and everyone backstage, and we're like, "That would be amazing. That would mean so much." And so we texted my mom, and she, with fear, said yes. And my manager quickly wrote out a little introduction, and my mom read it backstage and then basically crumpled it up and said, "Would you mind if I just spoke something from the heart?" And I was just so proud of her, and she was amazing, and she talked about my dad and just that they were both there, and it couldn't have been more perfect.